Pacific people have been in New Zealand for generations, some dating back as far as the 30s and 40s. Let's meet the Pamatato Davies family from Milford in Auckland. Mum, Edwina, Richard and Jane. Edwina is retired and has lived in the family home for over 50 years. Richard's a journalist and Jane a successful businesswoman. Edwina was born in the Cook Islands on the small island of Mauke, one of eight children. Her sister Jasmine Underhill was a former deputy mayor of Porirua. At the tender age of 11, she made the journey across the ocean to Aotearoa to live with her aunt who had no children.
I was 11, it was 1944. Yes, it was during the war years. And it took 7 days. I came over on the Maui Pōmari and it took 7 days for the ship to get to New Zealand. I came back with my aunt and two cousins too, and she brought the three of us back. New Zealand was big, and in the eyes of a child, anything, you know, it's big. And the trams, and Queen Street, and the wharf. And so anyway, we arrived in Auckland and then we went to Thames, where I grew up.
Edwina finished her education in Thames before becoming a nurse, something she'd wanted to do from an early age.
I was influenced by one of our local doctors who used to come to Mauke to do these annual checks, and I just thought he was the most wonderful. It was wonderful, this man who was so clever. So I decided then that I was going to go nursing. And I'd never changed my mind when I came to New Zealand.
It took Edwina 10 years to go back to the Cooks. By that time, she'd qualified as a registered nurse. She went back for a holiday but stayed 2 years before returning to New Zealand, where she then got married and had 4 children. And although she speaks Cook Island Māori, she mainly spoke English to her children.
It wasn't the thing because I had nobody to talk to. When we got to with the Cook Island girls, they spoke Cook Island. So did I, but mainly, it's half English and half Cook Island. You don't really hold a conversation in either English or Cook Island. It's usually half. And I think that's fantastic. You can't, things you can't express in English, so therefore you resort to your language, and it sounds great.
I remember when my mother would talk to family in the Cook Islands or in other places, and she wouldn't be talking English. We would be going, at times, this is a very strange sound that she's making. She's speaking in Cook Island Māori, and at one stage we were all laughing. I remember my siblings and I laughing, and she was talking to us, but afterwards she got very angry that we were laughing at actually what was a language, her language.
Is that something that you, perhaps, if you could do it again, would you have changed that?
Oh, yes.
Why is that?
Well, I think they've missed out. And I certainly would get them to learn to speak Cook Island Māori. And they have missed out on a lot of their background.
I wanted to learn it, but I haven't. I have done Māori at university and I have a degree in Spanish. So I speak Spanish. I speak French. I don't speak Cook Island Māori, but I think as you get older, you realise how important language is in defining part of you. And I think you miss out on something when you don't speak one of the languages that your parents speak.
Growing up in New Zealand, Edwina says she never experienced racism. However, she does remember the time her auntie changed her name to make things easier.
When I was going to school, my aunt had shortened my name from Pamatato to Pama, and I was never very happy about that. And then, because when I went nursing immediately, I went back to Pamatato because I'm very proud of my name.
And when his parents divorced, Richard decided to take on Pamatato instead of Davies.
It was a political decision, but also it allowed me to position myself in a really obvious way as somebody who is a Pacific Islander, who is also European, but everything is attached to the name, isn't it?
Growing up in Milford, their children were part of a small group of Pacific students at the local school. And the issue of identity is an interesting topic of discussion for the family.
If someone asks us what we were, I would say we're New Zealanders because we're born here, live here. And then, like Richard said, we have bloodlines from the Cook Islands, from Australia, from England, from Germany. So a real mixture.
You know, I'd go with the New Zealander as well, because we were born here, we are New Zealanders, but with all those strands.
You cannot deny that you are Pacific Island. Whatever we're not whatever you do, you cannot deny that.
No, because it's part of us. But it's only part of us, it's not all of us, because we weren't born there. We weren't brought up in a typical Cook Island fashion. We were brought up in a New Zealand fashion.
And you're always aware that it's a strand there, but it's not the only one. I think that's the big challenge for our generation.
As I say, you know, you can't deny any of that, but you can't say that you're just one thing. You're all of those things.
Jane is a successful businesswoman in Ohakuni and former Pacific Business Person of the Year. Richard's a journalist and worked for Radio New Zealand as the Pacific correspondent.
Says the problem is affecting the whole city, but appears to be predominantly in the Pacific Island community.
Having done well in her career, it was only natural Edwina wanted the best for her children. But did she have any expectations of them?
No, not really, because I knew they would do well in whatever they chose to do.
I think you did have expectations, though, because we weren't allowed to slack around. There was never a you can do what you like.
When you were quite strict, Mother.
Oh, yes. But then,
yeah.
Most parents are. Yes.
No, but quite strict in some very formal manners of learning correct way to do things. And so Edwina did a very good job on us kids with education. And just simple things from table manners, elocution, wearing really beautiful clothes, all of those just lovely, lovely things, which, you know, some of us get and some of us don't have.
And also with that comes a lot of basic foundation stuff. If you know your manners and you know the rules, you can know how to break them. And I think we've been given that foundation, education, manners, things that people forget about, but then you can break the rules and do other things.
They've actually been exposed to a lot of things. They've been very fortunate that they've been exposed to Papa'a ways and Polynesian ways.
The Pamatato Davies family has seen many changes over the years, but one thing remains true, their sense of pride about each other.
Mother certainly wanted us to be the best of ourselves and make the best. And so she certainly did give, you know, we did have a lot of opportunities. And then you've got an opportunity, it's up to you what you do with it.
And I think being the best isn't about being the richest or the smartest or the flashiest. It's about integrity, recognising all sorts of stuff. It's not about being some superstar, because not everybody can be that kind of person. You'd agree with that, wouldn't you?
I'd like to be a superstar.